Good morning, everybody. It is currently 8:08 in the morning. It's not actually this dark. I think it's because we got the curtain shut. It's bright out there. It's sunny out there. We're just in the shade, I think. The sun's coming up. We are heading to Universal Studios, so we've got to go down to the resort reception, and we've been using Ubers, so we are going to get an Uber to Universal, because I think it's slightly cheaper than getting the Mears yellow taxis, and we can just order it and pay by card and not have to worry about carrying cash around. So yeah, we've been using Ubers, especially to the shops and things like that. So hopefully the next trip you see, I'm going to try and put the camera by the window and get some cool shots out the window, but if not, you're going to see me at Universal as soon as this intro has finished playing. You're going to find out what we do, because I really don't know. We're like technically 15 minutes early. It doesn't open until 9, it's 8:45. It was open from 8 for people that can get in early. I think they are who stay here, so we're going to see what we can do. It might take us 15 minutes to walk up to the entrance, because you got to walk all the way through City Walk and then up round to a park. So we'll decide when we get there. Universal Studios with the classic Universal Hall shot. We're heading to Universal Studios Florida. Last time we were here, there was like Minions hanging from the bottom of that sign. So they've gone now, because the whole Minion thing's died out. We technically shouldn't be able to go in for another like 6 minutes. So we're hoping they let us in early. And we like to do a lot of things single rider here, because we don't get any pictures or anything. We don't need to be next to each other on the ride. And it means we can skip a lot of the queue, so hopefully that's still a thing and it'll be awesome. And yeah, we're going that busy queue now. So I'll see you on the other side. And this is our first view. A cool, like, taxi. Then you've got Minions straight away as you come in. Minion Mayhem. That shop there used to be a Betty Boop store, but it's not anymore. It was Hello Kitty last time we were here. I don't know if it still is. It doesn't. Oh yeah, Hello Kitty, yeah, the red part. But it used to be Betty Boop. We are probably going to head to... Do you want to go Diagon Alley? Harry Potter ride? Because that usually gets packed. We want to do the Jimmy Fallon ride. Because we didn't do that. That was new since we last been here. Oh, there is the Betty Boop. It is still here. This side is still Betty Boop. I thought they got rid of the Betty Boop side.
Look in the shops anyway, it's a lot hotter.
Yeah, when it gets warmer in the afternoon, we tend to go in the shops and the other things like Shrek ride or the Minions ride, because it's like cooler inside, basically. I'm guessing Jimmy Fallon's like that as well. What else we got ahead of us? There's a stage coming up on the left. They do like a Mardi Gras shows, bands come and play on it. I think 30 Seconds to Mars came here one year. We like missed them by like a day. So there you go, there's Jimmy Fallon's, that building kind of in front of us. There's a stage around there on the left, if I can just get it on the camera, there it is. And behind there's recording studio, so we watched a wrestling show once, TNA Wrestling. If anyone knows what that is, I'm a big wrestling fan. But you had to go in like that back far corner somewhere, and you go behind, and there's all like, there's actual proper stages back there where they record things. The Hollywood Rip Ride Rocket. I don't think anything, you could not pay me enough to go on that ride. It starts and it goes straight upwards, and then it comes over and does all the loops. And I think it plays music like around your ears. So I think it plays a different song every time. Well, I don't know if you can pick the song, I don't know. I don't want to know, because to know, I'd have to do the ride. But that's the one you see like celebrities get recorded on, because they put cameras on it. Oh, no. And that's the red track up ahead. It goes to like three buildings. All right, Chelsea's rushing off. And she's right to. But there's Jimmy Fallon. I'm excited to ride that. I like Jimmy Fallon. We've got Transformers. This park's really empty. I think it's because it's early. The guy in our Uber said today is like a, what did he say, a four out of ten in terms of busyness. If he'd have come like, this is the 22nd of August. If we'd have come on the 22nd of July, he said it would have been an 8 out of 10. Yeah, I'm watching, there's a curb, I know, I'm not falling over like last trip. If we'd have come like a month ago, 22nd of July, it would have been an 8 out of 10. So it would have been double the amount of people, which would have been amazing. Like, what? Here is Transformers. That's a really cool ride. Definitely going to do that. There is a Christmas shop here. There's a Christmas shop in basically every park, even at Disney. Disney has one. There was one at the mall. We went to the mall yesterday. So there you go, secret tip behind my vlog. We didn't actually go. This isn't actually the day after the last video. We actually had a day in between where we went to the mall and shopping and stuff like that. But there's even a Christmas shop at the mall. Like, what? It's August, mid-August. There is our Lord and our Saviour, Optimus Prime. Yeah, and that ride's good, but you can get on it pretty quick later on in the day, so I wouldn't worry about doing that at like park opening. You've got Simpsons kind of over in that direction. It's behind all those trees, you can't really see it. And up ahead, we head towards Harry Potter. Over on the left, we have Fast and Furious, and Harry Potter's just up ahead, so we're going to see the wait time of Fast and Furious. And then make a decision if we do this first, or Escape from Gringotts.
And you get to go on Transformers?
Whichever one we do, you can't actually watch us, because they're like video screens and rides, so you won't be able to see what we're doing anyway. But I can give you feedback. Okay, it had a 15 minute wait, but we've gone in the single riders queue. Which I don't know if that skips a lot of the cool stuff. I hope not. There's all like cars. Oh, I don't. They've gone in a completely different queue. I think we skip all the cool stuff, but. Ooh. We are going in the private party entrance. We VIPs up in here. Whoa, it gets dark in here.
My man. What up?
Sorry, brother Tej, no time for chit chat. I just sent you a brief on that FBI agent Novak.
I think you skip all the cool cars.
Yeah.
I don't mind.
You want to get a party at Sullivan's?
Sounds like a plan. That party is a
really good. You sad about that? I don't mind using the cars. If it means we get on the ride quicker, we can always look at the cars another time.
Okay, hold on. Let me get everybody squared away, and we'll talk offline.
Copy that, Tej, and let everybody know.
I think we do miss
shut
everything.
Shut off your cell phones. We don't want Shaw tracking your location.
Shut off your cell phones. Are you sure? We are literally like at the ride already. I can hear it. That's awesome. We like skipped everything. Okay, here is the ride. And we are literally both in row one next to each other. And now, King's Cross Station. Because we're going, well no, not that one. That goes through to the other park on the train. But we're going into this King's Cross Station because we're going to go through to Diagon Alley. Sorry, I mean Diagon Alley. Oh no, it's not King's Cross. What am I talking about? It's Leicester Square. My bad. There's the night bus. And there's the Simpsons in the background over there. But we are going through to Diagon Alley. Fast and Furious was good. It was okay. You see in a big car, there's like all screens around you. Similar to Kong, if anyone was on Kong. Quite loud. We were the only two in the car, it was weird. But we are now in Diagon Alley. Weasley's Wizard Wheezers. Get to focus for you guys. And there is Gringotts Bank, but we need to go drop our bags off before we do this ride. Which is a free bag drop, but it means I'm going to have to put the camera away, guys. So I'll just show you some clips around here. I can see people walking on with Butterbeers, I'm jealous. School robes. Daily Profit. Oh, take a picture of Chow. Huh.
Sure, I have one. Oh, and there's my picture. Don't know what's in there. It's a store. The dragon does breathe fire. I don't know if it does it this early, though. Ollivanders, the one shop. You can actually go in and they do the whole like wand process with you getting a wand, which is pretty cool. There's Hagrid's bike. Take a photo inside it. But we're going to go into Gringotts. But you have to go into just behind this, the building, just behind this big statue. And there are like lockers to put your stuff in. It's only a 20 minute wait, but we're probably going to go single rider anyway. So I'll be right back. As always, that ride is awesome. The dragon, I heard someone say, only goes off every 15 minutes. Butterbeer? Frozen butterbeer is amazing. Chelsea wants to come into this store because she wants to buy a pygmy puff, but a purple one because she's already got a pink one as a keyring. Squeeze for sound. Oh, I don't think you did that before. $18.95, but these are all pink. Chelsea wants purple. You can get frogs, toads. It's basically an animal store. It's a pet store. I can see the purple one in the distance. That shirt's cool. Oh my god, does she want one this big? $35. Oh my god. Slippers. They have pygmy pop slippers. And a t-shirt, maybe I'll wait. Chelsea went to the restroom, so I'm just looking around. And there's even Cornish pixies. Oh, it's a pixie. Should we get a pixie for pixie? $15. Oh my god. Crookshanks. You can buy a Crookshanks and get a Crookshanks t-shirt. Snakes in the window. And of course, Hedwig stuff. They're little like statues. I think they're statues. Magical creatures. Yeah, they're just like a statue range. And a t-shirt. Oh no, what's his name? Oh, that's gonna annoy me. Hagrid's dog. The dragon just went off in the background. I don't know if you heard that. Oh, look, there's more of these. Look, there's a fox, phoenix, Nagini. Oh, they're numbered. 4 is a Hungarian horntail, 5 Ukrainian iron belly, 6 buckbeak, 9 Nagini, number 1 is Hedwig, 8 is fox. Oh, look, and they've got these little like nano block things. Let's try and get that to focus. $18.95. I don't know why these things are so expensive. Every different type of one is, not just Harry Potter. We got the purple pygmy puff, which the guy at the till said this is a enchanted pet carrier made to look like a muggle plastic bag, so we're kind of in secret. Now Chelsea's got to think of a name. If you think of a cool name, tell me below. Or well, it may already be named by then. We can't say Pixie because that's our cat. There's a load of people lining up with their wands to do all the cool like things around here, so they're not on rides, that's pretty cool. I think, are we going to go look around the shops, the stores? Let's give you a look around. So yeah, the dragon only goes off every 15 minutes. And it went off while we were in the store, so I doubt it's going to go off anytime soon. Pumpkin juice, that's actually quite nice. It's pretty sweet. I had some. Right, let's get on to the next thing. I feel like we're about to take a bad turn. Porkin and Burks, that sounds like a nice store. Through what now? Oh, that looks healthy. I want a bottle of Skellagro. You can't buy this. It's awesome. What's in here? Oh, no, we're going the other way. I've been called back. Oh, it's a Nocturnally sign. OK, Okay, Nocturne Alley. Let's let the braver people go first. Okay, so it is a lot darker in real life. My camera is making this look bright. I love this camera. Ooh. It's very dark. I think there are some wand things around here as well. Yeah, that's what these things are on the floor. So there's one there on that screen, on that bit of wall. Spiders. Ah, cool, it's made out of newspaper. But there is Borgin and Burks. I think that lady in front of me works here. And Borgin and Burks, you can actually go inside and it has all dark magic stuff. Let's have a look in this store. This is the back entrance, I'm not going through. I think this is actually a fire exit, but you can see inside it's a store, so we're gonna head in there now. I think these people are doing wand things on a big screen. With a skeleton. But here is Borgin and Burks. Which I'm gonna head inside now. Borgin and Burks. All your dark magic needs. Wanted. Bellatrix Lestrange. All your Azkaban stuff. Have you seen this wizard? Oh, you can put your picture and be there. Have you seen this wizard? Or have you seen this witch? Photo frames. Skulls, of course, skulls. All Death Eater stuff. This is the creepiest store. There's the checkout for the till. Big tall thing behind it. Look at the cobwebs on the lights. That's a cool shout. A load of like jewellery and really everything. You can actually buy that Death Eater mask. It is $110. It's Lucius Malfoy's mask. Borgin and Burks shirt, that's cool. And by a snake. And there's the statue of him, like in the other store, the Nagini one. It's quite dark in here. You're wearing sunglasses, you couldn't see a thing. Have you seen this wizard? Or as a key ring? There's the evil one, undesirable number one. I found you, undesirable number one. Right, let's head out to the lighter side of life. I feel like they've added a lot more of those like wand things since we were last here. Going back into the light. Back out where we came in. This is where I originally wanted to come in. Chelsea went around that corner. Wonder if we'll get the dragon now. I've never caught this dragon on video once. Last time I tried and I missed it every single time. I'm just gonna stand here while Chelsea looks at something on her phone. Oh my god, there's a noise. Oh no, that's the wand thing. I don't think it's gonna happen. I think I'm gonna give up on trying to catch the dragon breathe fire. Right, we're going to more stores. Chelsea's trying to attach to the Wi-Fi. It took me a while to get on the universal Wi-Fi actually. I had to try like two or three times. It does, but it's slow. Like it either doesn't work or then it works. It's weird. Come on, dragon. Big money, big money. Got a great angle. It's an ice cream parlor. Florian Fortescue's ice cream parlor. That's the way we came in. So I want to head down this way. Under here. So this way comes out by the other kind of exit out of Harry Potter. There's this place, I think that's alcoholic drinks. There's like a fire whiskey one that the guy yesterday was telling us about that he gets every time is in Hot Topic, I think. Or maybe it's not there, I don't know. But I know there is a fire whiskey that is only made for, like, Universal, for Harry Potter. Oh, I'm out of focus. It's only made for here. You can get it with beer. So it's a beer with a shot of fire whiskey, so it's really good. He gets it every time. So we don't really drink, but if you're into that kind of thing, it's the only place that does it. So get it while you're here. Sugar Plum Sweet Shop. Oh, maybe it's there. Oh, it says Butterbeer up on the sign. A Hopping Pot. Oh no, Fire Whiskey. It's written up there in the red. Let's try and zoom in it for you guys. Yeah, we're going to Sugar Palms. There you go, Fire Whiskey. Zoom back out. And we're going to go to the sweet shop. Because you know for sure that your boy wants a chocolate frog. Sugar Plums. You can get all the merchandise on both sides, by the way. You don't have to go to one park for a certain thing, as far as I'm aware. So, like, the usual sweet shop we go to is on the other side. I don't think I've ever actually been in this one. But it's smaller. The other sweet shop's definitely bigger. Because this goes into something else, another store. Chocolate Frog is $10.95. I don't think I can get it to focus. There you go, $10.95. The every flavour beans are the same price. Look at those, Chelsea Sister. They do chocolate bars. A basic chocolate bar, let's have a look. Oh, it's thin as well. $5.95. I had these last time, peppermint toast. These are really nice. They are $8.95. There's a ton of things over here. Different things. We have, what are these? Caramel cobwebs. How much are they? $7.95. Tun Tong chocolate covered hard toffee and nuts. Oh wait, Tun Tong toffee. $9.95. We've got sugar mice. Choco balls. A chocolate cauldron. Oh, that's quite heavy. Is it solid?
There's a chocolate cauldron.
I don't think it's solid. I mean, I think it's slightly hollow, but it is heavy. And it doesn't have $9.95. Oh, Chelsea's showing me something. Oh my god, look at the cakes. Cauldron cake. Oh, you get it in the box. Pumpkin cake. Chocolate dipped pretzel wand. Witch hat cupcake. No melt ice cream. That's pretty cool. And then you got those different fudges. Butterbeer fudge. Oh. Wow, some of this stuff is amazing. Fudge flies. Yeah. Oh, jello slugs.
Some of them.
You want some of them? $6.95. I'll hold on to them. Okay. I'm not sure what I want. I wasn't going to get a chocolate frog, but now I'm curious. Don't know now. Okay, things are getting dangerous already. And now we're heading into the Weasley's shop. Oh, I love that Hufflepuff jumper. How much is that? Can you pass the shade attack? I don't love it for $110. Wow, $110. There's like the sports area now. Okay, it's got all Quidditch stuff. Oh, look at the baby. Oh, and the baby Gryffindor. Let's have a look around. Oh, Hufflepuff section in the corner. Let's go with my boys. Ooh, sneaking around. Get a scarf. Quidditch World Cup. Look at the Hufflepuff. Socks. Gloves.
Was this meant to have taken place? Was this advertised when the Football World Cup was on? It's cool though. Different. A ton of different stuff. Another Hufflepuff Quidditch. Team captain. Oh, the shorts are nice. A lot of Hufflepuff stuff is grey, which I don't like. I don't tend to wear grey very well. That's a nice shirt. $36.95 before tax. The towel's cool. But everything in Harry Potter is expensive. Compared to Disney, it's expensive, and that's saying something. I didn't see where Chelsea went. I'm guessing she went into the other half of the shop, which is the Weasley's shop. Yeah, she did. Oh, love potion. You trying to make someone fall in love with you? Oh, she's taking her. Oh, I think this is for her sister. I like the shirts. And the pin badges. They have pin badges. There was another shirt over here while I squeezed past Chelsea taking a picture that looked really cool. That one, look at that Weasley shirt. Colours on that are amazing. More pygmy puffs. Chinese fortune sticks. Jumping snakes. You know, yeah. You know poo. Here's that shirt. Oh, what are these? Creepy crawly spiders. Inflatable lips. Oh. Kylie Jenner got nothing on me. Inflatable tongue. Gene Simmons, I guess? I don't know. Oh, this story's amazing. Oh. Cupcake, the pygmy puff. Thank God we didn't buy one in here because that would have been embarrassing. I'm gonna get you on camera. I am gonna get you on camera. Oh my God, is this it? Is this it? Is this it? Is this it? It's getting loud, or is that just a pretend train overhead? There's a bridge above us. It's like 14 past. I don't know if it goes like every 15 minutes on the 15 minutes. It's not gonna happen. Oh, noise has happened. But it's not doing it. I have bad luck. Frozen butterbeer. Come on, dragon. While I'm here, breathe on my head. Do you want to go get them on our way out here? Okay, I'm gonna wait out here because I want to get this dragon. Come on, dragon. Chelsea's with the butterbeers, you're gonna breathe fire for me. Finally, after like 3 years. Oh, I'll be right back.